Hello and welcome kids once again to your science classes of grade 5. Kids, as you all know, now the summer vacations are about to over. So now you have to get back to your normal study routine. Okay, so here I am again starting the science syllabus of our science course book of grade 5th for UT1. We have already studied about two chapters, that is growing plants and food and health. So this is our topic third, that is safety and first aid. The explanation part of this chapter videos have already been uploaded before the summer break on your class YouTube channel. So first, it is being instructed to all of you that first you revise, first you watch those videos once more, once again, before starting the question answers works. Okay, because in this part of the video, I am going to discuss the book exercises plus question answers of this chapter, because that was only pending, while the explanation part of this chapter has already been uploaded on your class YouTube channel. Okay, so first you go through that, revise that, read the chapters, and then only you will start the written work in your science fair notebook. But let me tell you one thing, all the students, up to where you have completed your science UT1 syllabus in your science fair notebook, after that you will leave one blank page. Okay, you will leave one blank page to write the UT2 syllabus, and after that page you will start your UT2 syllabus written work in your science fair notebook. And obviously the written work will be started with the keywords of this chapter, and then question answer and diagram work. So let's start the book exercises of this chapter. This was the activity time in which you have to tick the pictures. According to my book, it is page number 27. It is chapter number 3, safety and first aid. Okay. This chapter was all about how could we remain safe. What is safety? What is first aid? What are the safety measures from fire? And first aid in different conditions, first aid for burns, first aid for animal bite, first aid for fractures, first aid for sprain, first aid for nosebleed, etc. Okay, so in this activity time, you have to tick the pictures where safety rules are being followed and cross where the safety rules are not being followed. So you can see this boy is putting candle and the flame is very near to his hand, so it is the safety rules are not followed because he is doing here and looking here. Okay, he is putting the candle wax here, but he is looking some other side, so it may burn his hand, so it will be crossed. In second picture, he is sharpening his pencil. This boy is sharpening his pencil with blade. Again, it is a wrong cross. This girl is very good because she and her mother, they are walking on the footpath and it is safe. And this small kid is walking with her mother, with an adult person. So it is correct. This student is again not following the norms. He is waving hand outside the window of a moving vehicle, which is very much harmful. So it will be cross. Now the next book exercise comes in page number 29. Okay, write T for true and F for false statements. First is, we should follow safety rules to avoid accidents. Yes, true. We should replace faulty gas pipes immediately. Yes, true. Faulty means defective. Immediately means at once. Third, we should wear nylon clothes while cooking. No, false. Because nylon is a synthetic clothes and synthetic clothes catches fire very easily. So we should put on cotton clothes while cooking or while working in the kitchen. Fourth, petrol fire can be put out using wire. No, it is false. Because if we will use water, then the water will keep, then the petrol will keep floating on the water and it will be burning. It will not be put out. Fifth, we should not strike a match in case of a gas leak. Yes, match means matchstick. When there is a gas leak by accidentally, then we should not strike out a matchstick or put on any light, because it may lead to the fire accident. So it is also true. Next is your keywords. First, you will write these keywords in your science fair notebook after leaving one page blank where you have completed UT1 syllabus. After that, you will leave one page blank, and then with proper date and day, margin line, chapter number, chapter name, you will start the and the heading keywords. You will write all these keywords. Okay, traffic signs. Traffic signs are the signs erected at the sides of roads to provide information to road users. Obviously, you must have noticed traffic signs while walking or going on the road. okay, they give information about what lies ahead on the road. Next is the tourniquet. Tourniquet is a tight bandage used for stopping the flow of blood through a vein or artery. Yes, tourniquet, this kind of bandage it is. When there is a bleeding or injury, it is tied on that body part so that the bleeding could be stopped. Fracture. Fracture is a crack or break in a bone. Sling, a flexible strap or belt used in the form of a loop to support a fractured part is called sling. This is the sling. Next is the splint, a strip of rigid material used for supporting and immobilizing a broken bone is called a splint. Whenever some body part got injured or fractured especially, then this sling and splint, they are used to provide maximum support to that fractured body part so that it could be recovered well. Next book exercise is tick the correct answer in page number 31. First is, what should be used to put out electrical fire? So either sand or mud or soil should be used. Okay, so sand is the correct answer. Because if we will use water, then there will be short circuit, because water is also a good conductor of electricity. Next, rabies is caused by, yes, rabies is caused by an animal bite. Okay, like dog and cats. Next, fracture is a crack or break in a bone, obviously. Fourth, a rigid support tied around a fractured part is called a splint. Okay, rigid support. A splint is the rigid support, a hard support which is being given in the fractured part. And sling is a loop. It is a kind of loose cloth thing or a loose belt type structure which is hang around the neck so that we could give support to that fractured part more conveniently. Okay, so it is a splint. Next book exercise is in page number, in my book it is in page number 32. Fifth, a tight bandage used for stopping the flow of blood is tourniquet. And one thing I would like to tell you all students, that first you watch the video carefully, then pause it and then start solving your book exercises, because some of the students commit lot of spelling mistake and it is very difficult to check that when you send the things in PDF form on the class group. Okay, so please do your work neatly, cleanly, without spelling mistakes. Whether you are doing the science work or SST work in your fair notebook or book exercises in the science book or SST book, it should be neat, clean and without spelling mistakes. Please mark my words and follow this. Okay, you have to be very extra careful while doing your written work. Okay, now you are at home, lots of time is there, so there is no question of getting writing verse. Your writing should be very beautiful now. Okay, so please take care of these things. You can see how neatly and cleanly I am writing the things. So in the similar way, you have to complete your book exercises. And all the book exercises will be done in science book or SST book only, book itself, in the chapter itself, okay? Only the keywords plus question answers plus diagram work in science will be done in science fair notebook, and keywords and question answers will be done in SST fair notebook, okay? Now the B, fill in the blanks with the correct words. We should be, two options are given, one is wrong, one is right. To avoid accident, so we should be careful. Switch, dash, the gas regulator when not in use. Switch off. Switch off means band kar dena. Third, use sand to put out petrol fire. Put out means bujhana, aapko bujhana, to put out the petrol fire. Fourth, do not wear nylon cloths while handling fire. Yes, blisters should not be pricked. Blisters, whenever there is a burnt, we suffer burn injury, then at that particular portion of the body part there is a blister, jise hum hindi mein bolte hain phode phunsi ho jana, phode ban jana, theek hai. Aur pricked means use hame prick nahi karna chahiye, use hame kisi nukile object se use phodne ki koshish nahi karni chahiye. We should not try to harm that blister. Wo apne aap hi dheere dheere after 2 or 3 days it will subside. Okay, so we should not be, the blister should not be pricked. Next, name the following. It should not be used to put out fire. It should not be used to put out petrol fire. So water should not be used. Second, it can be used to put out small fires. Fire extinguisher. As you can see, everywhere that red color cylinder Yes, this is the fire extinguisher. It contains certain kinds of chemicals or gas which helps to put out the fire, small fires. The small fires, for putting out the small fires, we can use fire extinguisher. Please take care of the spellings, okay? Third, the disease caused by animal bites, it is rabies. Two animals whose bite can cause rabies, so dogs and monkeys, okay? It is being mentioned in the book also. It is used to give first aid for bee stings, baking soda paste for bee stings. मतलब जब हमें कोई हनी बी या फिर कोई वैसे इंसेक्ट काट ले, जब हमें बहुत वी फील वेरी बर्निंग सेंसेशन, देन दिस बेकिंग सोडा पेस्ट. बेकिंग सोडा इज ऑल्सो यूज इन द मैन्युफैक्चरिंग, इन द प्रिपरेशन ऑफ केक्स एंड बिस्किट्स. सो इट इज वेरी इजली अवेलेबल इन द मार्केट, इन द ग्रॉसरी शॉप्स. ओके, सो यू ऑल शुड कीप सम बेकिंग सोडा पाउडर इन योर होम, सो दैट वेन एवर इट इज रिक्वायर्ड इट कैन बी यूज. सो वी कैन सिंपली मेक अ बेकिंग सोडा पेस्ट. ओके, टेक बेकिंग सोडा मिक्सड वाटर विथ इट, इट विल बी फॉर्म्ड इन अ पेस्ट फॉर्म, एंड देन वेर एवर देर इज बी स्टिंग इट कैन बी अप्लाइड ओवर देयर. इट विल गिव अ सूदिंग सेंसेशन, बिकॉज वेन द बी स्टिंग इज देयर, देर इज अ बर्निंग सेंसेशन. बहुत ज़्यादा जलन होती है, बहुत ज़्यादा स्वलन हो जाते हैं. तो आफ्टर अप्लाइंग बेकिंग सोडा पेस्ट ओवर दैट पर्टिकुलर एरिया, इट विल गिव अ कूलिंग इफेक्ट. ओके, सो दैट्स वाई इट इज बींग रिकमेंडेड दैट फॉर बी स्टिंग्स यू शुड यूज बेकिंग सोडा पेस्ट. Now, answer the following questions. There are seven question answers which I am going to discuss with you. Okay, so as you can see, I have written chapter 3, name of the chapter, question answers. You will also mention date and day, margin line, everything. Okay, you can also use pencil colors to highlight the important terms, important definitions, important words in the sentences. Yes, you can use, but avoid using red and green color. Okay, avoid using red and green color. Rest any color you can use to decorate your science or SST fair notebook. But in books, you will only use pencil to fill up the book exercises. Okay? In book, only pencil is allowed. I am asking only for highlighting the important terms and definitions. You can use the pencil colors. Okay, the first question, what is first aid? First aid is the immediate help given to an injured person before the arrival of a doctor. It can prevent the condition of the victim from getting worse. This you have studied in class 4th also, that first aid is the immediate. Immediate means at once, quick help given to an injured. Injured person, the person who has got hurt, जिसको चोट लगी हो. Before the arrival of the doctor, डॉक्टर के आने से पहले, whatever treatment the people in his house or wherever he has got injured, the people can give, that is known as first aid. और फर्स्ट एड इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज इट कैन प्रिवेंट द कंडीशन ऑफ द विक्टम. विक्टम हु इज द पर्सन हु हैज गॉट इंजर्ड, हु हैज गॉट हर्ट, दैट पर्सन इज रेफर्ड टू एज विक्टम इन दिस लाइन. फ्रॉम गेटिंग वर्स, तो उसकी कंडीशन और ज्यादा खराब ना हो जाए, उस कंडीशन को प्रिवेंट करता है अगर उसे टाइम पे फर्स्ट एड मिल जाए तो. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, हाउ विल यू गिव फर्स्ट एड इन केस ऑफ अ स्नेक बाइट एंड बर्न्स? यस, नाउ the questions will come that what will be the first aid in case of a snake bite and burns. So first aid in case of a snake bite, now you can underline this point. Okay, first aid in case of a snake bite, tie a tourniquet just above the bite to stop the flow of blood to the heart and rush the victim to a doctor at once. Yes, we have right now studied that the function of tourniquet is that it stops the flow of blood. Okay, so when the snake bite happens, then the snake is having poison. It insert poison in the body of the victim. Okay, and that poison quickly mixes up with the blood and it reaches to all the vital organs of our body like heart, kidney, lungs. So generally, normally what happens, the snake bite happens in near the leg area. Okay, so immediately we should tie a tourniquet bandage so that the flow of that poisonous blood could be stopped from getting into our heart or brain. And immediately, that is not a permanent solution. After tying a tourniquet, it will stop the flow of blood for a few minutes or for a few time. Immediately we have to take that person to the doctor so that proper anti-venom or proper anti-poisonous injection or whatever further treatment is there required, it will be given to him. So this was the first aid for the snake bite. Now first aid for burns. in case of a minor burn, minor means a small burn, hold the burnt area under cold running water till the burning sensation becomes less and apply an antiseptic cream or a paste of baking soda and water on the burnt area. Because right now I have told you, when there is burn, when there is bee sting, then also there is a burning sensation, jalan hoti hai. And वैसे normal अगर आप हमारे साथ ऐसा कोई accident हो गया, there is a small or minor burn injury, then also this baking soda paste, applying of this baking soda paste will work, okay, as a first aid. Okay, and first of all we should put the burnt area under cold running water, ताकि जो burning sensation है, जलन है जो skin में, वो थोड़ी कम हो जाए. Okay. Now, in case of serious burn, अब burns भी बहुत तरीके के हो सकते हैं. There are so many types of burns, minor burns, serious burns, chemical burns. Okay. So you have to write about each and every type. So in case of serious burn, immediately call a doctor. Blisters, if formed, should not be pricked. By in case of serious burns, we should immediately make a phone call to the doctor or take the person to the doctor nearby health center. And if the blisters have formed, वो जो फोड़े बन गए हैं जलन की वजह से, जलने की वजह से, उन्हें prick नहीं करना चाहिए. Let them be as it is. The doctor will give the proper treatment for that. Okay, so this is being suggested for serious burns. Now, in case of chemical burns, wash the affected area with plenty of water. Plenty means lots of water. And cover the burn with sterile gauze. Sterile gauze means a kind of bandage which is very much pure, very much clean. Okay, that is being sterile. Sterile means free from germs. Okay, germs se free kari hui cheeze, sterile gauze bandages are also available in the medical stores. So we should keep these kind of bandages also in our first aid kit and take the victim to a doctor. In each and every case, the last statement will be take the victim to a doctor, take the injured person to a doctor, because yes, first aid is not the complete treatment. Okay, complete and proper diagnosis and treatment will be given by a specialist doctor only. So the last line is very important, that take the victim to a doctor. After giving the first aid, you should take the victim to a doctor. Question number 3, what should be done in case of gas leakage? So in case of a gas leakage, we should open all doors and windows of the house and call an adult for help. And we should neither strike a match nor operate any electrical switches. Yes, if there is by chance any gas leak, तो that gas is very much flammable gas, मतलब उसमें बहुत जल्दी आग पकड़ती है. तो first of all we should open all the windows and doors of the house, ताकि वो gas जल्दी से घर से, उस कमरे से बाहर निकल जाए. And we should immediately switch off the gas regulator. And उस time पे we should not strike any lighter, any matchstick or even the switches, light switches, because it can also lead to a fire accident. So this is answer number 3. Question number 4. Explain how petrol fire can be put out. In case of fire caused by petrol, we should throw mud and sand instead of water to put out the fire. This is because petrol is lighter than water. It will float up on water and continue burning. Yes, आपको explain करना है कि petrol fire को हम कैसे put out कर सकते हैं, how we can finish it. Okay, so to in case of fire caused by petrol, I have already told you that we should throw mud and sand. If the mud and sand is available, जो रेत होती है, जो mud, कीचड़ या मिट्टी soil होती है, हमें उसे फेंकना चाहिए, उसे use करना चाहिए to put out the fire. Or we should use the fire extinguisher, or we should call the fire brigade. Okay, but हमें पानी की help से we should not put out the petrol fire, क्योंकि I have already told you petrol is lighter than water. वो पानी से हल्का है, it will keep on floating over the water. Okay, अगर आप पानी डालोगे तो भी वो पानी के ऊपर float करता रहेगा, and it will not be put out, it will continue burning. तो वो कोई use नहीं होगा उसका. Okay, so the correct is we should throw mud and sand instead of water. So this was answer 4. Question 5, how can you give first aid in case of an animal bite? Now, answer is in case of an animal bite, example dogs, cat, monkeys, we should wash the affected area with soap and water एंड देन अप्लाई एन एंटीसेप्टिक लोशन. एंटीसेप्टिक लोशन लाइक डेटॉल, लाइक सेवलॉन. ओके, देन कवर द वुंड विथ अ बैंडेज. यस, सो दिस इज द रिकमेंडेड फर्स्ट एड इन केस ऑफ एन एनिमल बाइट. इफ एन एनिमल बाइट हैपेंस, देन यू शुड वॉश दैट अफेक्टेड एरिया विद द हेल्प ऑफ सोप एंड वाटर, सो दैट वट एवर जर्म्स हैज कम टू योर स्किन ड्यू टू द एनिमल बाइट, इट मे बी वॉश्ड ऑफ इमीडिएटली फ्रॉम योर स्किन. So it is being suggested that we should wash the affected. Affected area means where the bite has happened in your skin, in your body, with soap and water, and then apply an antiseptic lotion. Then by taking cotton, drop some Dettol liquid or Savlon on that cotton and wipe that affected area. After washing, first you have to wash the affected area, then you have to wipe it with or apply an antiseptic lotion over there, and then you can cover the wound with a bandage, and after that again rush the victim to immediately to a doctor, because in some cases anti-rabies injection must be required or whatever is the proper treatment that the doctor will suggest. So taking the victim to a doctor is a very important point. You can write it as a first aid last line in every answer. Okay, next question: what is a fracture? Give first aid for a fracture. Now, fracture is a crack or break in a bone and the injured person feels more pain. Fracture क्या होता है? जब किस गिरने की वजह से या कोई एक्सीडेंट की वजह से, ड्यू टू एनी रीजन, एनी ऑफ द रीजन, द ब्रेक और क्रैक, हमारी हड्डियों में ब्रेक आ जाता है, हड्डी टूट जाती है, चोट आ जाती है उसमें, दैट इज ओनली नोन एज फ्रैक्चर. ओके, सो इट इज रिलेटेड विद द बोन इंजरी ऑफ आवर बॉडी. नाउ वट विल बी द फर्स्ट एड फॉर फ्रैक्चर्स? So first point is apply ice to the site of the fracture, wherever the fracture has happened. If ice is available, we have to apply ice ताकि जो swelling हो, जो चोट लगी हो, वो थोड़ा सा reduce हो जाए. Ice के apply करने से क्या होता है, जो swelling होती है muscles में, bones में fracture लगने की वजह से उसके ऊपर जो muscles है उसमें भी चोट लगती है, तो muscles में जो swelling आती है वो थोड़ी सी reduce हो जाती है. तो application of ice over that area could reduce the somewhat the swelling. Okay, next, we should keep the patient lying down and as still as possible covered to keep warm. अब हमें पेशेंट को, जिस पेशेंट को चोट लगी है उसे ज्यादा मूव नहीं करना चाहिए. वी शुड नॉट मेक हिम मूव एट ऑल. उसको लाई डाउन करा देना चाहिए, लिटा देना चाहिए, जितना आराम से वो लेट सकता है. बिल्कुल भी मूवमेंट ना हो उसकी बॉडी की, स्पेशली जहाँ पे उसके फ्रैक्चर हुए हैं. ओके, और उसकी बॉडी को कवर कर दो ताकि वो थोड़ा गर्म रहे, बॉडी ठंडी ना हो जाए. उस पर्टिकुलर फ्रैक्चर्ड एरिया को हम कवर भी कर सकते हैं, सो दैट उसमें थोड़ी सी गर्माहट रहे. नेक्स्ट, वी शुड नॉट मूव द पेशेंट अनलेस ही और शी इज इन डेंजर ऑफ फर्दर इंजरी एट दैट लोकेशन. ओके, दिस इज ऑल्सो एन इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट. लोकेशन मीन्स, मान लो पर्टिकुलरली देर इज अ रोड एक्सीडेंट, पर्सन का जो फ्रैक्चर हुआ है वो किसी बीच सड़क पे हुआ है, तो इट्स नॉट लाइक दैट ना कि आप बीच सड़क पे उसे लिटा कर एंड यू विल लीव हिम. नो, बिकॉज इट इज मोर डेंजरस. रोड्स आर मेंट फॉर द व्हीकल्स, व्हीकल्स विल कम ऑन कमिंग एंड गोइंग, तो इट कुड फर्दर हार्म हिम. तो हमें तब तक उसे मूव नहीं करना चाहिए, फर्दर मूवमेंट नहीं करनी चाहिए उसकी बॉडी की, जब तक कि हमें ऐसा ना लगे कि ही और शी इज इन फर्दर इंजरी, फर्दर डेंजर. अगर फर्दर डेंजर है तो विद द हेल्प ऑफ सम पीपल यू कुड लिफ्ट दैट पर्टिकुलर पर्सन एंड शिफ्ट हिम टू अ सेफ प्लेस. बट अगर वो ऐसी जगह गिरा है जहाँ पे कोई फर्दर इंजरी के चांसेस नहीं है, देन वी शुड नॉट लेट दैट पर्टिकुलर पर्सन मूव. ओके, सो दिस वॉज द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस पॉइंट. नेक्स्ट, वी शुड नॉट अटेम्प्ट टू री अलाइन अ ब्रोकन बोन बाय आवरसेल्फ. यस, समटाइम्स व्हाट हैपेंस, पीपल ट्राई देयर हैंड्स कि अरे ये तो हल्की सी मोच होगी, लेट्स ट्राई. रीअलाइन मीन्स वापस से उसको ठीक करने की कोशिश, कि कुछ नहीं हुआ होगा, मोच हुआ होगा, हम इसको ऐसे मोड़ेंगे या ऐसे करेंगे, ट्विस्ट करेंगे, तो इट विल बी ओके. नो, वी शुड नेवर ट्राई टू डू दैट, बिकॉज इट कुड फर्दर हार्म द इंजरी. ओके, उससे उसकी जो कंडीशन है वो फर्दर डिटोरियरेट हो सकती है, वर्सन हो सकती है. ओनली अ डॉक्टर पर्टिकुलर स्पेशलिस्ट कुड सजेस्ट प्रॉपरली दैट वॉट शुड बी डन. ओके, सो वी शुड नॉट अटेम्प्ट, वी शुड नॉट ट्राई टू रीअलाइन. रीअलाइन मीन्स फिक्स, रीफिक्स द ब्रोकन बोन बाई आवर सेल्फ. Next point is, when the patient is moved, we should make sure that a splint is used to immobilize the injury. If the fracture is in hand, Then a cloth sling can also be given for support. Now, of course, when there is a fracture, then the use of this sling and splint could be very handful, very useful. So immediately we should put this sling and splint to the fractured area so that proper support to the fractured area of that particular person body could be given. Okay. The last question is, describe safety rules to be followed in case of fire. So safety rules are, first, switch off the gas regulator when not in use. Yes, obviously every time you should also be very careful in your home, and you should tell these things to your parents, to your mother, or whosoever is using kitchen, that yes, they have to switch off the gas regulator when it is not in use. Second, replace faulty gas pipes immediately. If the gas pipe from where the gas is being supplied to the burner, if it is a faulty, if it is having a leakage or it is cut, then immediately it should be removed. Okay, because from there the gas will keep on leaking and it may lead to fire accidents. Third, check wiring and electrical appliances regularly for any fault or breaks in the wiring. Yes, it is also very important that whatever wiring, whatever electrical appliances we are having in our homes, we should keep on checking at them regularly, so that if there is some kind of damage, some kind of break in the wires or the appliances, it could be fixed well in time. As a now, okay, because of that default, some major accident could happen. So to prevent that, to avoid that, we should keep on checking the electrical appliances and the wirings regularly. Fourth, be careful while handling matchbox, candles and firecrackers. Yes, this is very common thing, that while handling all these dangerous things, or be not so dangerous, but these are some of the things which could lead to fire accidents. So while handling these things, we should be very extra careful. Okay, next, always put on cotton clothes when handling fire instead of synthetic clothes like nylon or rayon. Okay, yes, this is very important point, that whenever someone is working with fire or in kitchen or doing some fire related work, then he or she should put on cotton clothes only, because cotton clothes not catches fire easily, but the synthetic clothes like nylon, rayon, they catches fire very easily. So it should not be put on while doing cooking work. Okay, always put on cotton clothes. Next, in case of a fire accident, at once call adults for help and inform fire station its emergency number is 101. Yes, this number is very important. You also should remember this number. If there is any fire accident nearby your area, locality or neighborhood, so then immediately call the adults for help and inform the fire station. Immediately a phone call to be made to the fire brigade, fire station, whose emergency number is 101. So these are the six major points which, if we will follow, then safety rules, safety will be maintained in our houses, in our neighborhood and locality. Okay, so now the question answers have been discussed with you of this chapter. You can start doing your fair notebook work of science with chapter 3. First you will complete the keywords, and now I am holding this portion of the video for a few more seconds so that you could have a better look of all the answers once again. Okay. The explanation part of this chapter have already been uploaded on your class YouTube channel before the summer break only. So first you will go through that, then only you will start doing the written work or filling the book exercise work. Okay, and first you have to, I have already told you, after leaving one page blank, you have to start the keywords of this chapter. These are very important. First you complete these keywords, okay, neatly and cleanly without any spelling mistakes and with complete format. Date and day should be there, chapter number should be there, and chapter name should be there. If I am telling these things, then you have to follow the instructions. Sometimes some of the students are not writing chapter number, some of the students are not writing date, some of the students are not writing this heading keywords. What is this? You have to do your work very systematically, neatly, cleanly, without spelling mistakes, in a beautiful handwriting. And after completing the keywords, take a new page and then start the question answer. Again, you write down date and day, write down chapter number, chapter name, and write down the heading question answers, and then write question one, answer one like this. Now, coming to the diagram part of this chapter, listen very carefully, because time and again, you people being confused, ma'am, what diagram we have to make. So you have to make this diagram, first aid for fracture, the sling and splint. Okay, and this diagram could be made with the question number 6. Okay, question answer number 6. So you can make here diagram of sling and splint. Okay, and diagrams will always be made in the white page only. Here you are, suppose here this is your notebook, here you are writing answer number 6. So here in this white page, you will draw this diagram of sling and splint. One diagram, this is important. And next diagram, you can